Hey, it's my voice just cracked. It's Christine from Christine Peace, and this is part two of how to drive your roommate out or drive him insane. So that thing you call roommate still hasn't left. What do you do? Well, I've made a list. In the first video, I sort of told you some of the lamer stuff or tamer stuff, and each episode is going to escalate into, you know, further and further and into maybe crossing that line, you know what I mean? But here's some more suggestions. Watch your roommate sleep. This might take some time because you want that roommate to wake up while you're doing this. And before you can say anything, to say, I think we're done here. Get up and walk out. You can also play lava game. Lava game is everything that is floor or ground is hot lava and you can't step on it. So to maneuver around your apartment, you're going to have to step on furniture and avoid touching the ground. Anytime your roommate starts to walk on the ground, yell at him that his feet are on fire. If you're in an apartment building, you can jump up and down until the people below you come up and then just point at your roommate. See, I told you not to do that. And that'll work, especially if your downstairs roommate is like a biker. Speak to people that aren't there and try and eat your own face. This also gets you a seat on the subway. Anyway, whenever you come home, ring the doorbell so that your roommate has to answer it. Put your roommate's name on every mailing list you can find. Every mailing list. You can start decorating the apartment with crudely drawn pictures of, you know, penises and ball sacks, like really hairy and disgusting facsimiles that you just hand draw and then tape up all over the apartment. Remove the batteries from all the remotes and all the appliances. Carry a set in your pocket so when you want to use the remote, you just put them back in. But I hope this helps you in getting rid of your roommate. I have one more suggestion for this segment. It's a little more risky, but if you fake a heart attack, a seizure, or some sort of life-threatening thing going on, and your roommate has to call 911, by the time the paramedics get there, claim that you have no idea why he called and that you're perfectly healthy and fine. Haven't used that one yet. I'm saving that for a special occasion. So everyone, take it easy and tune in for the next episode.